Assalamualaikum and good afternoon to everyone. My name is Muhammad Farhan bin Ahmad Zubair, and today I will present my proposal for the study and analysis of the linguistic features used in translating the English subtitle of Japanese animation Flying Witch. So, as we all know, translation is not an easy task to be done. The job of a translator is to reproduce a certain text in a manner that faithfully release the original message, not only in terms of language, but also in terms of the cultural aspect. The translation also have to be pleasant and natural to the reader in the target language. This challenge is, this translation is harder if the two languages are different from each other. In my study, this will be between Japanese and English, which are totally different from each other. Furthermore, the challenges, the translation will be more challenging for subtitling because subtitles have limited space in for a certain sentence. So my objective for this study is to identify the linguistic features used in translating Japanese into English subtitle. The next objective is to figure out how subtitle can enhance the viewer's experience in understanding the story. To achieve this objective, the question that I pose for my study is, what are the linguistic features used in translating Japanese into English subtitle? And how does the subtitle enhance the viewer's experience in understanding the story? For the literature review, based on Shuttleworth and Kawi in 1987, subtitle is the process of providing synchronized caption to film and television dialogue. Wakabayashi, 1991, stated that translation between languages that are culturally distant does differ from translation between related language. In a study from Miyake, 2002, Japanese expression cannot be translated or transferred directly, as they need to be paraphrased to convey meanings in English. Based on my research of the previous studies, for the first one, a study of transfer from Japanese to English features seen in a manga by Miyake in 2002. This study helped me to build the base of the data collection for my study. And second one is translation between unrelated languages and culture as illustrated by Japanese-English translation by Jidi Wakabayashi in 1991, provided the basic knowledge needed for me to compare the Japanese and English in terms of translation. So for the methodology, I will be constructing a table consisting of the Japanese transcription and the English subtitle counterpart. English column, it will contain one sentence from each transcription and subtitle. It will look like this. For the left part will contain the Japanese transcription, sentence by sentence, and the middle one will have the English subtitle. And I will analyze in each of these sentence and put it, categorize it in the right column. As for now, I haven't done anything yet, and it will be done further into my studies. So, for the categorization, the features that I have found for now are adding subjects in English, or omissions of subject English, simplification of the meaning, or the transition of idiomatic expressions. For the idiomatic expressions, it can be a Japanese idiom into English idiom, or Japanese basic expressions into English idiom, or Japanese idiom into basic English expression. The next category is pronounce English instead of Japanese names, because usually Japanese will refer to someone in names, but English it will be unnatural, so it will be replaced by pronouns. And also the change of subjects, because the structure for English sentence subject verb object is different for Japanese, which have subject object verb. These are the just a draft of the categories, and I maybe will be adding more category or removing some of the category. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you.